Wrestling fans from Greenville, South Carolina's Memorial Auditorium. Welcome to another action-packed, exciting hour of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Wrestling the way it used to be and the way you like it. I'm Bob Caudle. This week we're going to be seeing Hollywood Bob Holly, Hustler Rip Rogers. We're going to see much, much more. We're going to be talking with... Hey.
You know, you never get finished. Why don't
Jim
you go ahead and introduce
me? The Louisville Slugger, right here, fans.
I'll tell you what we're going to see today. We're going to see two main events. Dutch Mantell takes on Scott Armstrong, and the Fantastics going up against the Koloffs. I can hardly wait to see Hollywood Bob Holly in action. I've heard so much about him. But Fantastics, I know what they can do, but I tell you this to the Fulton brothers, the Koloffs are out for blood in today's main event. I think they're going to get some. Bob, take it away.
All right, fans, it's going to be a great hour. You want to stay right here. You don't want to miss a sing a moment of it, and we're about ready to go. Let's go to the ring now and our opening match. This match is one fall with a 15-minute time limit. First off, at 215 pounds from Little Rock, Arkansas, Tim Fry. And his opponent, and at 228 pounds from Hollywood, California, Hollywood Bob Holly. And there he is,
sunglasses and all, and he's got that Hollywood tan, Jim Cornette. What, you say you've been wanting to, and you've been looking forward to seeing this guy.
Yeah.
You've been hearing a lot of things about him.
I don't know what you're chuckling about there, Mr. Caudle, because I tell you what, this guy is one of the most talked about newcomers in professional wrestling today, Hollywood Bob Holly. Look at the force. Look at the movement with every single thrust, with every single blow. He always puts extra emphasis into things.
Well, not only is he talking, we're talking about wrestling, but he claims he's in demand with all the casting directors in Hollywood. We're talking about Hollywood, Jim. We're talking about acting.
That's right. You know, he tells me all the casting agents want to get a hold of him. He tells me all of the directors, the producers, they want him to star in soap operas, major motion pictures, television shows, commercials, everything.
Well, he certainly is one of the most talked about newcomers in wrestling. Any doubt about that. But I tell you, I think he's going to have his hand full here. We're going to see, I think, a good, quick, fast-paced match.
Hey, wait a minute. Look at one of my friends at ringside.
Oh, no.
There's Ron Wright.
Yes, sir. Ron Wright, a legend in professional wrestling and now a top manager, I understand. Jim, what do you think? He may be down here scouting one of these guys?
I think that's exactly what he's doing because, you know, poor old Ron, his many years in professional wrestling have taken a toll on his body. He needs an operation. He's looking to make money, and he's got to have somebody to manage to make that money. He's probably scouting out Hollywood Bob Holly. I'll tell you one thing. Ron Wright has put more stitches in opponents' faces than Aunt Minnie puts in her homemade quilts.
Well, and that's why I keep saying, you know, how much sympathy can you have for a man like Ron Wright?
Now, wait a minute. I'll tell you what. Bob Holly on the receiving end here right now. Got that arm rung up, I should say.
Well, and he's got good leverage on that too, Jim.
Is that
up on
the proper
his tiptoes,
tennis?
Yes, sir. Got that foot right up into the midsection, does Holly. The whip to the ropes. There's Holly with a hip toss, and he hit the mat, and he hit it hard. But look how quick he got to his feet again, right back. And another arm drag, twice now. He's been taken down with the arm drag, and now the bar.
I tell you what, Hollywood Bob Holly getting wheeled around that ring. Ron Wright taking careful note of everything. We've got to watch out here. It could be an upset. Hollywood Bob Holly was the favorite coming into this thing, but this kid has really poured it on. Wait a minute. There he catches an elbow right to the chin.
Oh, man, and that was a flush one. He had all of his full force and power right behind that. The elbow dropped there right to the back of the head. Fans, we mentioned earlier, it's going to be a great hour. We got two tremendous main events in store for you. Scott Armstrong, that was Dirty Dutch Mantell. He may have him pinned. One, two, and he kicked out just at the count of two.
Big leg drop right across the throat. Ron Wright taking everything in. Also, later on today, we're going to see Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, one of the biggest stars in professional wrestling, coming here to Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Jim, it's going to be a pleasure to see him and watch him in the ring again, Orndorff. As you say, he's one of the greats in professional wrestling. One, two, only two, what, he kicked out again.
He had him down, but I don't think he was actually trying to beat the man because Bob Holly, he had a lax cover. I think it was more of a humiliating tactic because Bob Holly has things well in hand right now. I can see the people all over the Hollywood Hills are going to be in love with this guy when he comes back with this match under his belt.
Well, the Irish Whip off of the ropes, and again, Fry ran right headlong into that big foot, and he had that foot high into the air. It caught him flush right across the face, the nose and the mouth, and now
I wonder
Bob Holly is really going at him with those foot kicks and those stomps.
I wonder if Bob Holly could
take me. He may suplex him, Jim. Watch.
Well, he might. Yeah, he did. I wonder if he could take me to lunch at Spago's. That's a big place out there in Los Angeles. Big restaurant out there.
Big restaurant out there.
Yeah, I guess you wouldn't know anything about that.
Are you going to pick up the tab if he takes you out there?
You probably
You're
never.
That kind of person.
You've never been to Los Angeles. But wait a minute. He's fighting back against Holly. Sends him into the ropes.
And as you say, maybe a good upset. That arm drag and a takedown again and again. He's worked a lot on that arm of Holly's. He has that arm again, and he got high in the air. He got all of his weight right down across that arm muscle that time.
Well, maybe these guys are both know that Ron Wright is at ringside scouting the talent, so maybe they're both trying to impress Mr. Wright. I'll tell you what, he was a tough one in his day.
All the way across the ring. Corner, but he ran headlong right into the elbow. That time Holly saw him coming, got the elbow up in just the nick of the time, and boy, that had to loosen some teeth.
I tell you what, he's going to be sipping soup through a straw, and now a big slam right in the middle of the ring. Where is Holly going? Wait a minute. We've heard he's famous for his top rope technique.
And a big knee drop off of the top rope, Jim. High to the air. Look how
there
he got with that knee drop.
Brother,
oh,
Hollywood.
Heavens alive.
Oh, now he's taking those straps down. He loves it now. Hollywood, Bob Holly, that would have knocked out a bull moose.
All he has to do is turn him over and put the shoulders to the mat. 1, 2, 3, Jim, and there it is. The winner. Holly the winner, and I tell you, we can go back and look at that again in slow motion, huh?
I tell you what, a slow motion instant replay of that beautiful top rope. That reminds me of beautiful Bobby Eaton, a man that I know real well, right off with the knee, and that's all she wrote.
And there you have the winner, fans. Bob Holly, Hollywood Bob Holly, and we'll be back in just a moment. We're going to be talking to the Koloffs and about their big main event match coming up.
Bobby Fulton, last week, yes, it was the end for your career, but your stupid brother had to come and stick his nose in the match. But you see, this week, we are going to finish it with my nephew, Vladimir. As you see, you think all you people out there that Nikita was awesome. Well, you take a look at Vladimir. He's got the same intent in his heart. We're going to rip you apart. Fantastic. Today will be the end of your career, Fantastic.
Fans, if you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
We had an opportunity to tape some comments from rock and roll Robert Gibson. Right now, let's hear what Robert had to say about Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
You know, it's a pleasure to be out here now with Smoky Mountain Wrestling. You know, they gave me the opportunity to come out here and say hello to all the nice fans around the country. Let me say one thing. You know, I've been out for a while. I had a serious knee surgery. I've been out for like 9 months. Now I'm back. I'm ready to prove the world. I'm back here ready to come back to wrestle. I'd like to say one thing. If all the fans out there can stick behind the rock and roll will never die. See ya.
One fall with a 15-minute time limit. First off at 222 1/4 pounds from Seymour, Indiana. Hustler Rip Rogers. And his opponent, weighing in at 235 pounds from Tampa, Florida, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
All right, fans, this match one fall. Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, Hustler Rip Rogers, and Jim Cornette. We've known Paul Orndorff for some time. He's a tremendous world-renowned wrestler. He's wrestled top-flight competition all around the world. And I tell you, I'm delighted to have him right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Well, I tell you what, Paul Orndorff is another one of these guys that, he's a tough guy, and I'll give him credit for it. And he disdains the show business approach to professional wrestling of a lot of the big promotions these days. That's why he's come to an area where he can compete man on man, one on one, without being fancy, without having to sell dolls and t-shirts and things like that. The only thing I don't like about Paul Orndorff is he's always playing up to these redneck stinking hillbilly fans around here.
Oh, come on, Jim. No, I tell you, the fans love him, and he loves the fans.
They love
the competitor he is and the type of competitor he is in the ring, and he gives you 110% every time he gets in the ring.
Does that win him any wrestling matches? No, it doesn't. The way to win wrestling matches is what Hustler Rip Rogers is doing, and that's the way you get ahead around here. You win wrestling matches.
Rogers right out of the shoot is coming out real hard at Orndorff, and he just slinging him, whipping him around the ring, corner to corner, turnbuckle to turnbuckle. Now here's Orndorff with a reversal. There goes Rogers in, off with a hip toss. Boy, he got Orndorff upset.
Oh, I tell you what, Hustler Rip Rogers, he says he's the best conditioned man in professional wrestling, but if Paul Orndorff keeps up this pace, brother, he won't get a chance to find out how long Rip Rogers can go. Wait a minute, right in the cameraman's mouth.
And right out of the ring, there he goes, hard to the, right to the side of the ring, to the apron. And I think now Rogers, he's going to be slammed into that barrier, right around the ring, that steel barrier.
Brother, he's got the ring announcer's microphone. Now, wait a minute. I don't know whether that counts as a foreign object or not, but look, Paul Orndorff.
Look at Orndorff. High off the ropes with the elbow drop right to the top of the head of Rogers.
I guess Commissioner Bob Armstrong's doing like they do in the NBA. He's letting them play. No blood, no foul. And Paul Orndorff and Hustler Rip Rogers waking these people up right now. Let go, Rip!
Rogers really got off on the wrong foot, Jim. He came out, he attacked Orndorff. Orndorff didn't even know what was happening.
Oh!
Before Rogers really went at him, tooth and nail. And Orndorff now just fighting fire with fire.
I'll tell you what, he's fighting Rip with his fist. That's exactly what he's doing. Boy, this is the kind of action that you can expect from Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And I know that all these people out there are waiting to find out how that they can bring Smoky Mountain Wrestling to their own little redneck hamlet and out of the way village.
Well, let's tell everybody to get their pen and their paper handy, Jim. We'll tell them a little later on. We'll give them the address.
Well, I knew you were going to do that. I'm going to try to get out of here while you do that, because I don't really want to go to a lot of these towns in this part of the country.
Orndorff still held onto the arm. Rogers going to try to whip him. Look at there. Rogers got high in the air right over Orndorff. Orndorff scooped him up with a power slam. Just scooped him up, slammed him hard to the mat. The arm drag again, and Orndorff right back to the arm.
Paul Orndorff staying on the offensive. He has main evented from nearly every major arena in the country. Madison Square Garden in New York, the Forum in Los Angeles, and everywhere in between. But with the state of professional wrestling these days, he's had to come here to Smoky Mountain Wrestling to find some competition. Because this guy loves to fight. I know that for a fact. And he's not above breaking a few rules time after time.
Rogers just clawing around right down the back of Paul Orndorff, raking those nails down. Orndorff had to break the hold, and there goes Rogers with that forearm, and he caught him right across the throat with it. Going to kick and stomp him now as Orndorff is helpless at the moment, down on the mat, off of the apron, down onto the floor.
Back
and Rogers right out after him.
Hey, brother, you know, that's what they're doing around here. If we want to fight man on man, that's exactly what happens. And Hustler Rip Rogers is a never-say-die guy. He is not going to give up. He's going to do whatever it takes, anything in his power to win a wrestling match.
Hard right to the back goes Orndorff, and he's hurt now as he's very slow to get to his feet. Slammed hit first right into the top of the chair, the seat of the chair.
Scooter Leslie, our ring announcer, I think, is vacated for greener pastures.
Can't blame him, Jim. Get the heck out of there, guy.
He's gone all the way back to Rock 101, the out-of-control room here in Greenville, South Carolina.
Yeah, Rogers helped Orndorff back into the ring. Just literally threw him back in on the mat and right back in and after him. That's Rogers. He's got that elbow. And he dropped it. High, standing right up on his toes to get all of the force and power he could behind that and get as high as he could with that elbow right down.
That's the thing about Rogers. He does everything with a lot of emphasis. He executes perfectly.
He's got the sleeper on him.
He's
got
the sleeper. Let's see what Orndorff can do about this. I don't care how big and how strong you are. You got no blood going to the brain. You're not going to win a wrestling match.
And Orndorff is out near the center of the ring. He's a long way from the ropes. He's not going to get any help here from the ropes. And it looks like Rogers has got it locked in tight, Jim. He may be going out.
He's got that carotid artery pressed in under the chin. That's what the sleeper does. It cuts the flow of blood off to the brain. It renders you unconscious. Just like standing up too fast after you've been laying down a long time. I know you'd know something about that, Bob. But Orndorff's fighting. He's trying to shake Rogers off, and Orndorff is a bigger man.
Round and round he goes, trying to rest into the corner. Rogers with his chin right into that turnbuckle, and he smacked that turnbuckle hard. But Orndorff is still face down on the mat in the corner.
I'll tell you something, Rogers is not going to give up. That's the thing about Rip Rogers. He's not bad about
he's
Mr. Orndorff's reputation.
Small package.
Imagine what it could do for Rip Rogers' reputation for his career to get a television win here over a man the caliber of Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Jim, there's no doubt about it. He was going to try to get him up for the suplex. He couldn't hold him. There's Orndorff. He turned the tables on him as he had Rogers high in the air, and he really hit the mat hard.
I think he had some tights there as he took him over, Bob. I'm not sure, but I think he did.
Look at that big knee lift.
Wow. Mackerel took him out of his boots.
All of the power. Orndorff got a running start for that power knee lift. And Rogers down and down hard. Now he says, wait a minute, back up. I think he wants a little moment here to shake those cobwebs loose and get a breath.
Look at the closed fist by Paul
Orndorff. He's got him locked in the ropes, too. He's hung in the ropes. He's helpless at the moment. And Orndorff just measures it right in the nose.
And Paul Orndorff, he's a southpaw, bringing that left fist into the nose, sends him off. Rogers, beautiful move, countered effectively.
Well, Rogers has put up a whale of a fight, no doubt about that, against Paul Orndorff. Mr. Wonderful looked like he was going to try to get him in position for a pile driver.
Pile driver, he would have been disqualified, but Orndorff backdropped him out of it. Can he get him over? No, he didn't.
Drops the knees to the shoulders, and he's going to, he's going to pin
him. He got him.
One, two, three, he did it. What a whale of a match. A lot of action and excitement in that one. Yes, sir. Hustler Rip Rogers and Paul Orndorff. And, Jim, we can go back and take a look at that in slow motion.
Well, I tell you what. If Rip Rogers had executed this, he would have been disqualified. The pile driver illegal in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. But Orndorff instead sends him over in the backdrop. Rogers tried to hold on for a sunset flip. Orndorff balanced, dropped down on the man's shoulders. One, two, three, Bob.
All right, and fans, we'll be talking with Primetime Brian Lee when we come back right after this. Wrestling fans, we want to invite you to continue watching each week right here on this station, Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Wrestling the way it used to be and wrestling the way you like it. The big news, of course, is that very soon, Smoky Mountain Wrestling will be coming live to your town. And you'll be seeing such outstanding stars as this man right here next to me, Nitro Danny Davis.
Thank you very much for the introduction. You know, I am proud to be associated with Smoky Mountain Wrestling because it's been a long time since I've been in the area. It's also been a long time since the wrestling fans around here have seen live wrestling. And it's like you said, there's nothing like live wrestling. So whenever Smoky Mountain Wrestling comes out, come out and see us. I'm looking forward to seeing all my friends from the past because for years, many years ago, I was a name here. Most fans remember me as Nightmare Danny Davis, but that's a thing in the past because now it's Nitro Danny Davis because just like a ball of nitroglycerin, you get too close and shake me up, I'm going to explode on you.
One of the many stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling fans, Nitro Danny Davis. Now let's talk with the commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Mr. Bob Armstrong. Bob?
Bob, it's good to be with you. I've got a list right here of some of the top wrestlers in the country and another list back here of some that negotiations are going on with as we speak. What Smoky Mountain is trying to do is bring the sport of wrestling back as a family feature, something you can bring your children out to enjoy and not be ashamed of at affordable prices. Some things have gotten out of context. I'm not going to allow any breakage of the rules, no pile drivers over the top ropes. You know all the things we've gone over. I've gone over it with the wrestlers, and fines are going to be handed out. Fines are going to be levied on anybody that breaks the rules. So we will try to make it a family affair, like I say. And like you've been talking about, it's much more fun to watch professional wrestling in person. TV matches are great, and we've had some great TV matches, good tournaments to come. But if you take my word for it, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is a place to be. Come out and see us when we come to your town, and come see us in person.
Fans, here's a young man that's bringing a lot of excitement to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. We're delighted to have him, prime time, Brian Lee. Brian?
You know, Bob, Dutch Mantell come up here and run his mouth. You know, it's easy to sit behind the desk and criticize somebody. Dutch, I'm 6'5", 285 pounds, and not hard to find, and can't hide behind much. So if you got a problem with me, I can settle anytime, anywhere.
All right, and that's the message, fans. It looks like you're sending that right to Dutch Mantell, Brian.
You're exactly right. Dutch Mantell and any other takers.
All right, fans, we say this young man has wrestled, he's wrestled in Puerto Rico, he's wrestled in Japan, he's wrestled all around the world, and he's going to have a big impact on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Prime time, Brian Lee, don't forget that name.
This match is 15 minutes, one fall, first off at 215 pounds. From Marietta, Georgia, Scott Armstrong. And his opponents. Weighing in at 234 pounds from Oil Trump, Texas, here is Dirty Dutch Mantell.
Where in the world is Oil Trump, Texas?
Oil Trough, Texas, I believe it's just about 35 miles down the highway from Cut and Shoot. I'm not sure. Dutch Mantell, a good friend of mine, a broadcast colleague, a color commentator, and also I've known him as a wrestler for quite some time. Scott Armstrong's going to find out he's bitten off more than he can chew here. Yeah. The Dirty Dutchman, he's wrestled everywhere.
Well, he has that, Jim, and as you say, he lives up to that name, Dirty Dutch Mantell, no doubt about it. I'm not surprised that he's a friend of yours, by the way. But I tell you this, Scott Armstrong, he's a tremendous youngster. I tell you another thing, I was not surprised, but I was delighted to hear Brian Lee say that he's not going to put up with any lip from Dutch Mantell. And that guy's big enough, strong enough, powerful enough, he can back up what he says.
What he ought to do is he ought to back up and get another profession. He ought to back up clear out of professional wrestling. Brian Lee comes out here running his mouth. Dutch Mantell's a veteran. He's an experienced wrestler. He's trying to criticize Brian Lee, tell him what he ought to be doing. Brian Lee can't take criticism. Well, Dutch Mantell can dish out other things besides criticism. Brian Lee's going to find that out.
Scott Armstrong, he's got Mantell in the armbar. Scott Armstrong, he's from a wrestling family, Jim. Lot of experience. Factor, he grew up around wrestling. He knows wrestling. Wrestling's been a part of his life ever since he's been a youngster.
Yeah. You think by now he'd have learned a decent trade, because I tell you something, the Armstrong family, the whole bunch of them, he's the son of Commissioner Bob Armstrong, who says, I'm not going to play any favorites. I'm going to lean over backwards to not be a favoritism to my son. Let me tell you something. Commissioner Bob Armstrong has his friends, just like every other politician. And this Scott Armstrong here, you know, as a matter of fact, when Scott was little, Bob used to walk him to school every day. It came in handy because they were in the same grade.
Snap Mauer out of the corner. Now with a chin, here's Mantell. He's a rough, tough customer. The rougher, the better. Mantell likes it. I tell you, he's wrestled all around the world, Jim. He's made a name for himself everywhere, and especially with that bullwhip of his called Shoe Baby.
That's exactly
right.
Oh,
man, he's deadly with that thing.
Dutch Mantell just brings that bullwhip to the ring. The referee now asking if Dutch was using illegal leverage. I'm sure he wouldn't do a thing like that. Well, see,
he's got the rope again, and he's almost got him in the stretch.
He's just trying to wipe some sweat off the palm of his hand so he can apply the hold better. You see, Dutch Mantell's bullwhip, Shoe Baby, been all around the world with him, traveled everywhere that he's been. He just brings it to the ring to show that he's not going to stand for people trying to run roughshod over him. He would never dream of using it during a wrestling match.
Now, Mantell, again, right in plain view of our camera. And fans, you got a good view of it. The fact that he had that rope to get all that extra leverage in. Hey, wait, now we got a little TT going here with a referee.
Well, see, this little referee, that little punk, he should know. Wait a minute, Scott
Paul
Armstrong.
Hawkins, he rolled him right up in it. Very quickly, he almost had him down for the count of
four. Oh, he missed the drop kick.
Yes!
By heavens, he got high into the air for that. Very quick, Mantell got out of the way of that one.
He went up there. There was nobody home. And when you're expecting to push off of that with force and there's nothing there, but now a short clothesline, it throws Scott Armstrong's equilibrium off severely. Knee to the back. Dutch Mantell vicious when he's on the attack.
He is that, and he held that hand to give a little more leverage of Armstrong coming off of the ropes to get that short clothesline in. Now Armstrong trying to shake his head, get his thoughts back, get some of those cobwebs out. Mantell has been on the attack. The Dirty Dutchman lives up to his name. He went to the eyes. He's done a little bit of everything in this match.
Hey, you got to fight fire with fire sometimes, because this Scott Armstrong, he's obviously broken every rule in the book. Look at his closed fist right now. Ever since he's gotten in the ring, he's tried to break every rule in the book, and Dutch Mantell is merely responding in kind. Look at that. He hit him with the fist.
High fist, and that one was high onto the top of the head, and another hard right hand from Armstrong. Mantell holding on to that wrist by the hair, and down he goes to the mat. With a wrist now, as Mantell is on his feet, and he's got a leverage factor on him right now.
Look at this referee ought to get down and kiss Dutch Mantell's feet that he is allowed to referee a match with an experienced veteran, a great big star like Dutch Mantell. Instead, he's harassing the man.
Mantell now with that hard right hand again, and that time you saw Armstrong go right through the ropes and off of the apron and down onto the hard concrete floor, and look at Mantell go right out after it.
He couldn't have been hurt. The floor was there to break his fall.
Mantell just slings him back into the ring. Right back in quickly on the attack comes the Dutchman. Off the rope. Hey, good move right there by Armstrong. He held a rope and got to put up in another one now. That one right into the chin of Mantell.
Look at those closed fists. He's going down. This looks like like a boxing match. We're talking Mike Tyson and Larry Holmes here. What is Scott Armstrong being allowed to do?
Rights and lefts, and he drives Mantell into the... Watch out, he's got that bull whip. There's Shoe Baby right in the hand.
He caught him in the throat. I told you, Dutch Mantell's not going to stand for this.
Well,
beat.
And the referee saw it, he's going to ring the bell. Woo! Mantell, he's
going
to that bull whip.
He's going to light him up, brother.
Woo! He said ring the bell, it's all over. There's Brian charging into the ring.
Hey, what in the world is Brian Lee? What kind of business has he got getting in this ring?
Hey, Scott Armstrong.
Oh, come on in.
Scott Armstrong is your winner. Under disqualification. Wait a minute, Dutch has got...
Hey, Brian Lee, let me tell you one thing. You stick your nose where it don't belong. This whip will stop a 2,000-pound bull. And you keep messing with me, I'll whoop 75 pounds right off you, brother.
Oh, there you have it, Bob. He's not going to take this abuse.
That's what the Dutchman, Dutch Mantell, says, and fans will be back right now. Let's take time out for this. Fans with me right now is Mr. Jerry Williams, who's principal of Morristown, Tennessee's East High School. And Jerry, recently you had a Smoky Mountain event in your school.
Bob, yes, we did. Had a great turnout of fans. I'll tell you what, Smoky Mountain Wrestling brought top-notch wrestlers into the area. We had a great time, and I tell you, these people are easy to work with, and I'd recommend that they bring them into their school if they need to raise some funds. The East High baseball team is taking advantage of this situation.
Fans, you can get all the information by writing to the address on your screen right now about Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Fans with me right now, Smoky Mountain Commissioner Bob Armstrong. Bob, again, it appeared to me, and I think all of the fans, we call it Dutch Mantell, he used a foreign object in the ring.
Well, he's used his whip, and we'll say he tried to get around the foreign object clause, but he can bring that whip to the ring if he wants to, if that's part of his paraphernalia. But if he uses that whip, it's going to cost him $500 the first time, and we'll see what happens after that. Now, still talking... As long as we're on the subject of Dutch Mantell, he seems to have a problem with Brian Lee. So we here at Smoky Mountain can settle that problem. Next week right here on TV, we'll put Dutch Mantell against primetime Brian Lee next week.
Fans, that should solve that problem. Wait a minute. Don't approve of that?
What, Commissioner Gordon over here got to stick his nose in everybody's business? I would pay that fine just for the privilege of seeing Scott Armstrong get bullwhipped. Now, I'll tell you something else while we're on the subject. People want to know other people's business. Everybody's been asking me, Jim Cornette, who's this tag team you're bringing?
Yeah.
Who's coming to Smoky Mountain Wrestling? Who's this dynamic new team? Well, nobody's going to know until I'm ready. And when I'm ready is going to be when they decide champions around here, because that's exactly what these two guys are going to be. You see, I've been in some of these other organizations. I know how it works. You want to get a wrestling match maybe up a little higher on the card? No way. You go in there and say, I want to be in a main event. They say, no. You're not selling enough bubble gum cards. You go in there and say, I want a little more money. We can't pay you no more money. This guy's got a contract selling tennis shoes. We got to pay him. You want a title shot, worst of all, they say, uh-uh. We ain't going to give you no title shot because you might beat that guy and take his title, and he just signed a contract to be on an episode of a situation comedy. So you see the problem in other wrestling organizations. Around here, brother, the way that you become a champion is by winning a lot of matches. The way you win a lot of matches is by having more guts in your belly than the guy you're standing across from. And when you get that title match, the only thing between you and that belt is whether you're bigger and better and tougher than the guy that wears the gold. My men are going straight to the top, and ain't nobody going to stand in our way. And if these rednecks like it, that's fine with me. If they don't, I could care less.
Something we're going to look forward to in the near future. Who is that team? And we'll be back right after this.
Fans, if you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling at your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
Fans, with me right now, Mr. Wally Yamaguchi of Power Channel Television, Cable Television of Japan, and Universal Wrestling of Japan, who is here to scout the talent and also understand to look and think about exchanging some of our television programs.
Yes, Bob, I'm very pleased that I'm at the Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and we're here to try to televise in the future moment, and we like to exchange talent, and I'm having fun, and This is our logo, and this is my boy from Tokyo. And we're all here from Tokyo, and let's put the Smoky Mountain Wrestling Worldwide International.
Hey, yeah, okay? Maybe we'll be seen shortly in Japan then.
Sure, sure, sure.
Well, and good luck.
We're very pleased that you're here, and you should be a pride that you're in one of this program of Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
All right, thank you so much, and it's a pleasure to have you here with us. Fans, before we have tonight's main event, let's go back and look at what happened last week in the match between Ivan Koloff and Bobby Fulton. And I want you to pay particular attention to what happened at the end of the match after the match was over. Right now, let's go back and see that.
I'm just glad they didn't hurt Mr. Wright.
Well, here is Fulton now with right hands and drives Koloff to the ground. Koloff draped over the second rope, and he is now out here. Right now, there is Wright, is over to shake the hand of Koloff.
Shaking his hand, a good sportsmanlike gesture.
And Koloff with a right hand, he just about turned, he did. He turned the lights out. He turned Fulton's lights out with that right hand. Did Wright give him something outside of the ring?
The winner of this match is Ivan Koloff.
Here comes Jackie Fulton in, and Jackie now complaining to the referee. Koloff is saying no.
Now what's he complaining about?
Well, Jackie, I think, is saying here is he and Koloff now slugging it out.
Now, this is not right. That's not fair. Jackie Fulton is not a very sportsmanlike man coming in the ring like that and attacking. Ivan Koloff had just wrestled for 10 minutes.
Wait a minute, right here, there's an object. He did give Koloff something. And the referee's going to reverse that decision, it looked to me like, as he's over now. Here comes Vladimir. We got the Russians.
Well, that's good.
Fantastic.
That's
all
good.
Four of them in the ring.
Well,
we got chaos right now.
That turnabout's fair play. Did he reverse that decision?
Was that accidental by Wright or not? When he reached up the hand or to shake the hand of Ivan Koloff. Now, here's Jackie Fulton being choked. Ivan Koloff has got the chain.
Is that Vladimir the nephew?
That's the nephew. That's Vladimir. He's a big one, too.
Oh, he is a big one, isn't he?
Over the top rope now. And Bobby Fulton is being hung right there over that top rope. Or is that Jackie? That's Jackie.
Now Bobby's up.
Yeah, here's Bobby Fulton.
That is the greatest thing that I've ever seen in my life. Oh, Fantastics finally got what was coming to him. I hate a couple of bleach blonde stinking punks like the Fantastics.
Jim, they tried to hang Jackie right there, and I think he would have still been hanging there.
Should be
if
hung.
Somebody hadn't come to the rescue. It ended it out about that. Well, shortly after that, at the end of the program, Commissioner Bob Armstrong, he
stuck
came
his
over,
nose in.
He joined the Fantastics, and they had a discussion about this. Now, let's hear what they had to say about what happened. Fans, what a wild, chaotic finish to that match. Here the Fantastics and Commissioner right here, Bob Armstrong.
Let me interrupt right here. You know, I told you that a foreign object will not be tolerated. Right here it is, right here on this paper. That's a rule.
Yeah.
Ivan Koloff, you're going to be fined $500.
Wow.
And as a matter of fact, while we're talking about Koloff, if they want to fight each other's battles, we can settle that. I tell you what, I'll sign a match next week right here on TV, and we'll put both the Koloffs against the Fantastics. How about that?
All right, what about that, Bob? What about that?
Hey, yeah, I'm going to go sign it right now, boy.
Thank you, Bob. Hey, listen, let me tell you, a lot of things are happening around here. I couldn't agree with Jim Cornette more. They're bringing it back to wrestling what it's about, the way the fans like it. Now, Koloff, I've been hit with fists before in the past, and by yours. And I don't know who that goof was in the wheelchair, Bob.
Right.
But he handed something to Ivan Koloff. My brother seen it. Hey, we just want law and order. Like Bob, the commissioner, said, Armstrong, right? He's going to sign this match next week as a main event. Well, let me tell you, bald-headed commie geek, something right now. This is Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Things like that aren't going to happen. We're going to fight fire with fire. Hey, Bob, they jacked my jaw, and I'll tell you, they tried to publicly hang my brother right on TV. We thought about a fresh wrestling start. Well, we see that when the Koloffs are around, things are going to start a little different, and it's their way. Hey, like I said, we're ready to fight fire with fire, and as long as those great people of the United States get behind us, we know that we're going to do one thing. That's kick tail, just like we did overseas against Saddam Hussein and those characters. We're going to do it with Ivan Koloff and that no good other nasty ball-headed Koloff. And let me tell you something, Ron Wright. That's his name, right? The guy in the wheelchair.
Right. That's right.
You may be crippled and you may be an old man, but brother, next time you interfere in my match, I'm going to pick you up out of that wheelchair myself, and I'm going to kick you straight in the booty, because regardless, you shouldn't have got in the ring. You shouldn't even been ringside. And hey, Bob.
Ron Wright maintains his innocence. Ron Wright maintained his innocence through all of this. So before we went on the air today, he had these comments. Let's hear them.
Let me tell you something, Fantastics. I don't know what you're all upset over accusing Ron Wright of getting down there and trying to give that man something. Ron Wright is a crippled man. I'm in a wheelchair. All I'm doing is coming around here looking at the talent that Smoky Mountain has, and believe me, brother, they have plenty of it. And you know Ron Wright has never harmed a hair on any man in my opponents in my life. Just poor old crippled man sitting here trying to mind my own business, looking at what's going on here in this Smoky Mountain Wrestling Empire, and I may get me a team or a man that I may sign up under a contract to manage that can make me a lot of money to have my hip surgery.
Fans, if you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
This television main event at one fall with a 60-minute time limit. First off in the ring at a combined weight of 250 kilos from the USSR, Ivan and Vladimir Koloff. And their opponents. You see the bad blood between these two, this team and these four, as the Fantastics came charging in and went right after the Koloff.
And brother, they are going to town just like we knew they would after last week's altercation. And of course, Commissioner Bob Armstrong, he's going to let the Fantastics do anything that they want to do because he's that way. He's going to take care of his friends. And there they have the Koloffs on the floor after all these cheap tactics.
Jim, no, he is going to be completely unbiased. He's going to be completely fair in all of this. And he's going to be sure that everybody plays by the same set of rules. I'm sure that's what Commissioner Bob Armstrong is going to do.
Yeah. And by the way, every time you lose a tooth, you still look under your pillow for 25 cents from the ferry, don't you?
Hey, there's a lot of bad blood, no doubt, between these teams. The Fantastics, they're a tremendously popular tag team specialist. I think they've got the edge on Vladimir, not on Ivan, of course. But it's going to be, I think, speed and quickness here against power and strength. And that's the way these two teams stack up.
Well, I'll tell you what, the Koloffs definitely are powerful, definitely are strong, have a big size advantage over the Fantastics, and what's more, Ivan is no stranger to tag team wrestling. No. He's held the NWA World Tag Team Championship on several occasions with different partners.
Well, you're right there, Jim, but I tell you, I haven't had a chance to really get a good look at Vladimir. Vladimir hasn't been over here too long because Ivan brought him over from Russia. By the way, what is 250 kilos? I have no idea.
I think that's probably about 15 to 20 years in prison. I tell you what, this is a wild match, you know, but that's what Smoky Mountain Wrestling is all about. As bad as I hate the Fantastics, I will say that they never give up. They never say die. I guess it's because they're too stupid to know when they're beat. But that's what this is all about, tough competition. May the best man win. In this case, the best men are going to be the Koloffs.
Well, Commissioner Armstrong, Jim, you mentioned him earlier. He's trying to enforce all those foreign object rules. He's trying to give the referees some power to keep the match in hand and under control, and that's what the referees need.
You couldn't give that referee power with a Thompson sub machine gun. Look at him. Where'd he get that haircut?
What a fantastic. They're quick. And they're using that quickness to their advantage as they double team Ivan over in the corner. Bobby Fulton in.
Big monkey flip, but Jackie Fulton was holding the man from behind.
Well, now Fulton goes to do it right again. Out of the corner. There he came and he didn't have any help. Got the knees right down on the shoulders, almost into the bridge.
Beautiful chain wrestling from both these guys. That Ivan Koloff, he is a wily veteran, and he has taught nephew Vladimir some of the tricks of the trade. Vladimir already at his tender time so far in professional wrestling, already wrestling like an experienced veteran. Boy, did you see the way they wrapped that Russian chain around the neck of Jackie Fulton last week?
They tried to hang him from the top rope with that chain.
Oh, nails Vladimir off the apron of the ring. Referee does nothing about that. Jackie Fulton's tongue was lolling out like a long red necktie. Now here comes Jackie Fulton.
Well, he leapfrogs right over Bobby Fulton, right down across the arm of Ivan. And I tell you,
You got to say that the Fantastics, they're pumped for this match.
Yeah, they're pumped all right. Suicide Blondes died by their own hands, pumped all that peroxide up. It's gone to their brain. It's affected their thinking. There's no way they're going to beat the Koloffs.
Now Ivan down on the mat. He's under a tremendous amount of pressure in that arm. You could see the pain and the anguish in his face as he was really being just driven and held to the mat right there by the Fantastic.
I want to say a word about something too, Bob Cullen. I'm sick and tired of all these people around here persecuting Ron Wright, making accusations, making statements about the man. He is a kindly old gentleman who's never harmed a hair on anybody's head, said a crossword, just like he said. And I don't see why that these fans have to keep picking on him, trying to instigate two things, instigate trouble. The man's trying to get an operation.
Again, last week, right here on this program, I think all of the fans that were watching saw Ivan Koloff take something out of the hand of Ron Wright. When he did, he really lowered the boom on Bobby Fulton.
Speaking of Bobby Fulton, he almost lowered the boom on Ivan Koloff, but Koloff kicks out at the count of two. I tell you, he was just giving the man a hearty handshake, wishing him well, Ron Wright was, Ivan Koloff. Now, Ivan, we're catching him, giving some signals to nephew Vladimir.
He's trying maybe to moving him to another corner.
Oh, I see what the strategy was. He brought Jackie Fulton down the apron. Beautiful.
Well, you talk about right there, the experience advantage did not work to the Fantastic's edge.
See, Ivan Koloff, the ring general, he signaled his man down to the neutral corner, drew Jackie Fulton down. This is a game of physical chess, just like professional wrestling has historically always been before the past few years. These guys are going to have to outsmart and outfight each other to get ahead in Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Well, there was a double elbow that time as Fulton came off of the ropes after the tag. And here's the big one. This is Vladimir.
Whoa! Scooping boom!
Breaker coming right down. Jimmy had him high in the air. The big guy is strong.
Broke
as
him like a biscuit.
He is. Oh, man, he had him so high in the air. And all of that power right down across that knee.
Fulton got the leg on the ropes. That's the only thing that prevented the pressure.
He missed the elbow. Oh, he missed the elbow. Vladimir high in the air. He was going to send him right out into next week with that elbow. Here comes Ivan. Ivan runs right into a right hand into the midsection. And Fulton now with those rights to the jaw. That'll slow up anybody, though, when you go to the eyes. And that's exactly what Koloff did.
And this Bobby Fulton in particular, this guy, he's had too many chairs laid across his head. He's been in too many rough fights because he just never knows when he should give up. I've had trouble with the Fantastic for the past 5 years in professional wrestling now, and it's always the same thing. It's like trying to stamp out a nest of cockroaches. You can't make them give up.
Bobby right now needs a tag. He needs to get to the corner. Jackie Fulton over in the corner, over the rope. Bobby hasn't been able to get over. The Koloffs have already tagged and made another switch.
And you see Uncle Ivan has ingrained in nephew Vladimir to keep the man away from his corner. Cut off that ring. That's exactly what they're doing now. Ivan Koloff with a little subterfuge. They're going to keep Bobby Fulton away from the tag that he so desperately needs.
Well, he does that, and they're going to try to wear him down. They got him hurt now, and they got him reeling, and if they can keep him from the tag, Jim, they can wind it up. It's going to be a good win for the Koloff due to the fact that Vladimir is not really schooled much in tag team wrestling. It'd be a good win for the Koloffs over the Fantastic.
Wait a minute, sunset flip!
He's got him pinned. Come on! One, two, three, let's go!
You see, Jackie Fulton couldn't leave well enough alone. Had to be harassing the referee. That's what caused the downfall of the Fultons in that particular pinning combination.
Jimmy could have counted 10 if the referee had been looking at him.
Don't exaggerate, Bob. Leave that to the politicians.
Right into the chain, a big Ivan Koloff over the top turnbuckle. And Fulton's head just slammed hard to that turnbuckle right in the chain. Look at that big, heavy leg. As Koloff got high to the air, he got all of his weight down across that leg, dropped the count of two.
I don't see that Bobby Fulton, I don't see he can take much more. I really don't. They have been keeping this pressure up. And the people, Jackie Fulton trying to get all these idiots behind the Fantastics. That's what they thrive on, fan support, the Fantastics. They really genuinely believe that, and that's why I think they're so demented, because these people are not going to get you anything except get your butt kicked.
Well, Bobby Fulton now needs a tag, and he's been trying to reach out and get to the corner. Ivan turned around very quickly and just slugged Jackie Fulton, knocked him down off of the apron. There's a headbutt from Ivan as he backs Bobby Fulton back to the corner, and it's the Koloffs that make the tag, and they got the fresh man. They're going to double-team Bobby Fulton now.
Beautiful double vertical suplex. Once again, an old veteran's trick. He drew Jackie Fulton into the ring while the referee was putting him out. They make the double-team and the switch.
Vladimir had him covered, but he didn't hook the leg, and again, Bobby Fulton kicked out at the count of two. But again, he's unable to reach over and make that tag now as Jackie Fulton still outside the ring. It's been nonstop action even before the bell as the Fantastic came charging into the ring, went right after the Koloff, and in Jim, no time at all. The bad blood that has brewed between these two is just something to behold.
And Fulton takes him over. He's going to try for that tag, and he ducks the clothesline, gives him one of his own. I'm watching this match because
that's
I know
tag.
That my team, as soon as they're revealed, is going to have to fight maybe both these teams in order to become Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions. So I'm going to be scouting all these tag team matches, and Fulton right now trying to get to the ropes, but the Koloffs make a tag, and the Fultons do too.
Yes, sir. We got two fresh men in. Here's Jackie Fulton and Ivan Koloff. Jackie high to the air with that drop kick. Nice. Drop kicks Vladimir. And you saw the USA flag out there with the Russians in the ring and the chant of USA.
Drop kicks, body slams. Jackie Fulton is a house of fire. He's going nuts.
In the headlock. Oh, is he going to flip them both? And he does.
Now all four men are in the ring, Bob. The Fantastics and the Koloffs pairing off. It's a Pier 6 brawl just like we knew it was going to be. But wait a minute. Was it? Yes, he's out on the floor. Jackie Fulton knocked out on the floor. Bobby and Fulton's in there by himself.
He's going to be double teamed from behind. There is Koloff. Ivan and Vladimir Koloff now with Bobby Fulton as they whip him to the rope. Oh, he got Ivan right into the arm muscle and the chest with that foot.
Cross body.
Flying cross body coming from Jackie Fulton. One, two. Did he pin him? Yes, sir.
Wait a minute. Was he the legal man?
Fantastics, Bobby and Jackie Fulton.
What a quick ending we had right there, Jim, and a surprise not only to the Koloffs, but I think to everybody, whether he was legal or not, we can take a look. Let's go back and watch it in slow motion.
I don't know whether Jackie Fulton was the legal man. I think this whole thing, the referee lost complete control, the high crossbody off the top on Ivan Koloff. The referee goes down to make the count. He was right there at their feet, count of three, but I just don't know.
The Fantastics over the Koloffs, fan. We'll be talking with White Lightning, Tim Horner, right after this. Wrestling fans, remember, for the best in action and excitement, be sure you watch each week right here on this station for Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Wrestling the way it used to be, wrestling the way you like it. A number of outstanding stars, and we'll be letting you meet one of them in just a moment. In addition, we've also have tremendous and great managers. One of them right here, Jim Cornette.
Are you trying to insinuate I'm not a tremendous and great star? We'll meet one of them in a minute, but first, here's Jim Cornette. Let me tell you something. You know, we're coming back with live professional wrestling in all the towns in the Smoky Mountain Wrestling area. You know what that's like? An albatross. That's a big, ugly bird that hangs around your neck, bringing doom and destruction everywhere it goes. That's what going to these redneck hillbilly towns is to me, an albatross. I'm calling Bob Armstrong. I ain't going to these stinking towns.
Speaking of stars, fans, one of the greatest ever in professional wrestling right here, and here he is. All the wrestling fans around the country know this man, Terry Bam Bam Gordy.
Well, Terry, that's right. You know, it's like this. I've been from Freebird Mountain all around the world. I've been from Freebird Mountain to Tokyo, Japan. I've been from Freebird Mountain, like I said, all around the world, but this is the first time I ever came from Freebird Mountain to the Smoky Mountains. Right here I am. I'm ready to take. The bombs are starting to fall. Can you hear? Get out! Get out! Get out! Get out! The bombs are starting to fall. And I'm going to be the one that drops the biggest bomb of all right there in your town, wherever the Smoky Mountain Wrestling goes. And I'll guarantee you this, the skies over your town is going to be illuminated.
Ends at Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and don't forget, it's going to be coming live soon to your town. Fans, right now we're talking to Morristown, Tennessee's own White Lightning, Tim Horner. Tim, I know you had a very successful tour in Japan, but I also know that you're glad to be back here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling, back before the home folks and in your own area and territory.
That's right. You know, when I come home, you know, I think of mountains because there's mountains all around us. And when I think of mountains, I think of Smoky Mountains. And now every time I hear Smoky Mountains, it's Smoky Mountain Wrestling. You know, and I really get excited about that because finally there's an organization who is going to allow the wrestlers to compete at a level that they're capable of competing in. You know, some of these other organizations, you know, and I talked to the commissioner earlier today, Bob Armstrong.
Right.
He assured me that Smoky Mountain Wrestling is not a body competition. It's not body
building.
Body
yeah, muscle,
building. There
right.
You go. And it's certainly not a rock show. You know, some right. of these other organizations, you know, they want to hammer something into the people's head, if you get my drift. But, you know, I'm happy to be here, you know. And like you said, I just come off a tour of Japan, and I'm really happy to be here.
Fans, that's it from White Lightning Tim Horner. Next week, Dutch Mantell, Brian Lee. That's our main event. We'll see you then, and until then, so long for now.